Well, some breaking news coming in at this hour. This is in fresh revelations thanks to the Pegasus snooping, the entire scandal over there. And this one tells us that the Karnataka Congress leaders in the run-up of the change in government there, the falling of the Congress government there, did Pegasus have a role to play in that as well? Well, this fresh news report that has come out from The Wire, the latest round of revelation, it says that in the run-up to the toppling of the opposition-run state government in Karnataka in July of 2019, numbers of deputy CM, personal secretaries of H.D. Kumaraswamy and the former CM Siddaramaiah, they were on the list. Joining us for the latest on this, Arvind Gunasekar. Arvind, tell us more about what this report actually entails.
Sonal, another report has come via relating to the Pegasus news series, and this is something that relates to Karnataka. So what the story was actually saying was that during the entire Karnataka political crisis, when the government of Congress, JDS alliance, that is Kumaraswamy as chief minister and Congress in the alliance, that particular government was toppled in Karnataka, during that particular time, the phones of who's a senior leader of Congress, and also the aides of Siddaramaiah and also Kumaraswamy were snooped to this particular spyware Pegasus. So this is a big revelation that has been made by The Wire, which is doing a series of reports based on the Pegasus database, the numbers that have been part of the Pegasus database, which shows that those numbers were, at the relevant period of time, were snooped through this particular Pegasus software. So this is a big political story. It clearly, according to The Wire, it shows that during that particular relevant time, when there was a political crisis, when that led to the fall of the government in Karnataka, the numbers of these three important functionaries, Kumaraswamy, Siddaramaiah and Parameswar, all three very important functionaries, not just in the respective political parties, but also in the government, in the Karnataka government during that particular time, were snooped through this particular Pegasus spyware. So this is something, a big revelation that has been made by The Wire. And what we are learning is that the Congress party will address this shortly. The Congress, all the Congress senior leaders, including Mallikarjun Kharge, Adhiranjan Chaudhary, and also Randeep Sujawala, who is the general secretary of Karnataka, will be addressing the pressure shortly. And what we are also hearing is that simultaneously, senior Karnataka leaders, both Siddaramaiah and also D.K. Jayakumar, who is the current Karnataka Congress president, both of them are meeting Rahul Gandhi today evening. And what we are being told is this will be discussed, and the Karnataka Congress party wants to take it to the streets of Karnataka, to the people of Karnataka, to show how the government was toppled by snooping through this particular spyware.
Well, not just political. If this is true, it will be a legal matter as well. Arvind, the report also says that the records indicate that the phone numbers of key players, and you pointed that out earlier, appear to have been selected around the time when an intense power struggle was taking place between the Bharatiya Janata Party and the Janata Dal Secular Congress-led state government in 2019. And it also says this period also coincides with the selection of a new number that Rahul Gandhi began to use after discarding an earlier one he had been operating earlier. So Operation Kamala is what has been called earlier. All of this happening during the time their phones were, according to this report, tapped on.
Sonal, look at the name. Parameswar was the deputy chief minister during that relevant time. And it says that the report, the Wire report, says that the Parameswar's number was also snooped. He was the deputy chief minister of the government. Second is the secretary of both Kumaraswamy. Kumaraswamy was the chief minister of that particular time. And also Siddaramaiah, who was an alliance leader of the entire alliance. So all these three important functionaries, at least two, one chief minister and second one is deputy chief minister, both their numbers and their associate eight numbers were under snooping through this Pegasus spyware. So that's why, like you mentioned, it's not just a political story anymore. This is why the party wants to take it to the people, saying that those two people were chief ministers of constitutional post. What they are saying is that even the chief minister was snooped through his aide, through this particular Israel spyware. That's why the Congress party wants to take it. They want a judicial inquiry. Earlier we were told that Congress wants a joint parliamentary committee probe into this matter. But with these new names, new revelations making way, what they are saying is that they don't want a joint parliamentary committee probe anymore. They want a judicial inquiry. They want an inquiry that to be charged by either a retired Supreme Court judge or a sitting Supreme Court judge into the entire Pegasus spyware scandal. And what they are also countering the government is that the government, as on responded. They have not come clean, not even once. Even yesterday, when the Minister of Electronics and Information Technology, when he made a statement in the floor of the on the floor of the House in Lok Sabha, he did not categorically deny that we did not buy this particular spyware from Israel. So these are the allegations that the Congress Party is making, and we have to wait for the pressure of what the Congress Party will again put forward the pressure shortly from now.